Jake here for American Trucks, and today I'm taking a look at the RB20 running boards in textured black, fitting 2019 and newer Sierra 1500 crew cabs. Now, these running boards are going to appeal to the Sierra owner who's looking to add some protection, some off-road style, and some functionality to their truck. These are high-quality steel running boards that make a rugged visual statement and bring some added protection and versatility that go perfectly with your Sierra style. Now, running boards are some of the easiest mods that you can make to your truck, and unlike a lot of other modifications, they can serve multiple purposes, like these RB20 boards. Such as the case for these RB20 boards. Now, of course, the primary function of any running board is access to the cab. At the front, these are going to measure 7.5 inches wide, and they taper to about a 6.5 inch width towards the rear. And they provide you with a wide, solid foundation on which to put your feet all the way through front to rear. Now, for somebody who's a little bit shorter like I am, I find these kinds of steps way more helpful than the smaller ones, such as like a Nerf bar. This is a good stable platform to lift yourself up on, and it's especially going to be helpful if you've got a lift on your truck or if you're planning on fitting one in the future. Now, the nice part about these being full length of the wheelbase is that you get access to the front and rear doors, but also to the inner part of the bed. So you can just step right up, reach right into the bed right behind the rear bulkhead and be able to access that as well. You also have this punched hole design that's gonna help improve grip by letting water and debris drain off. And it's gonna give the tread of your shoes something else to grab onto. Plus, it just kind of looks cool too. Little bit of that diamond pattern type of thing. And that brings us to the other big benefit here, and that is the protection that these offer. Now, as you can see from the truck in the shots here, looking at these on the table in front of me, these are a pretty low profile design. So they tuck up pretty close to the rocker panels of the truck. In fact, they kind of flare up right here at the edges. So if you are doing any off-roading, these are gonna provide you a lot of protection to those rocker panels, but it's not gonna seriously affect your ground clearance or your brake over angle. So you're not sacrificing much capability by putting these on. And the tough construction means that if you do happen to hit them on something or they get hit by something, whether it's out on the trail or in a parking lot somewhere, they can take the beating and keep on kicking. Now, speaking of that construction, the steps are made from heavy duty 16 gauge steel. And this steel has been both zinc coated and galvanized to help protect against rust and corrosion. And of course, it's finished off with this nice textured black powder coat as well. It's gonna add yet another layer of protection. That black powder coat finish also helps bring a little bit of extra grip by texturing the steps here. And with all that, I think it's safe to say that these are gonna stand the test of time, even if you live in a harsh climate. The bottoms of the steps are also pretty open, so they're not gonna retain moisture in the same way as something like a tubular step would. And you also get some seriously heavy duty brackets that are included. This is just one of them. And these are finished in that same texture black powder coat as the steps themselves, and they're made out of the same type of heavy gauge steel. So again, just like the steps themselves, these are gonna be able to withstand the test of time and whatever you can throw at them. Now, when it comes to the price, these are gonna be a little bit more on the expensive side. About $600 is the going rate, and that's gonna fall towards the top of the category as far as price goes for fixed side steps. Now, they're not gonna be quite as expensive as some other large steps or the electric folding steps, for example. However, I think these represent a good value because of that construction, the clearance they provide, and the accessibility factor. So with all that taken into consideration, $600 really isn't too bad. As far as installation goes, these are gonna get an easy 1 out of 3 on the difficulty meter, and they should take you about 2 hours to get the job completed and have everything mounted. Now, you get all the hardware and the brackets that I talked about earlier in the box, and there's no cutting or modification needed to the truck or the steps themselves. So this is a pretty simple bolt-on installation. And to show you that process now, let's go ahead and hand it over to one of our AT customers.
All right, so here's just a quick little explanation of what tools I'm gonna be using here to install my running boards and my 2021 GMC Sierra Elevation. So here I got my half inch socket. It's kind of hard to see. A half inch ratcheting wrench, because why not? 13 millimeter socket, 13 millimeter ratcheting wrench. Got my ratchet. Grabbed a 3 inch extension. I've got longer and shorter if I need it. Then this isn't really called for, but I'm gonna use this little pick, this little 90 degree pick here to pull out those plastic caps that it talks about in the frame if I need to. If I can't dig them out with my fingers too easily, I'll use that. Let's welcome to the underside of my truck here. So right now I'm just trying to figure out where I need to mount these brackets. So the directions actually say, hold the bracket up to see where, to determine the location of your threaded holes. I'm thinking it's gonna be this guy here and this guy here. Pop these out. There we go. Hole number one located. Yeah, I would definitely recommend, in addition to the tools that it tells you to get, a little 90 degree pick or a screwdriver or a pry bar or something along those lines to help pull these guys out. I got these from a pretty cheapo hardware store. I think it was like $7 or $8 for the set. So if it breaks, not a huge deal. There are a pair of pliers, pull these things out. There we go. Bracket number one. Start threading these bolts in. Oh, it's 6-inch extension. Probably not gonna fit in up there, but we'll need it for the bottom. Thread that guy in. There is not a whole lot of resistance on these going in, which is nice. I was a little worried on the hardware that the powder coating that they put on there was gonna prohibit them from going nice and smooth like they are. The next set that I'm gonna install here, you know, all the way down here, and try and space them out as evenly as possible. So I got a set down here for the rear, and another one about there. And this next spot here, looks like there's two locations that you can put this in. Here and here. Get the light over there too. Well, here and here. I think I'm gonna go with this rear set because it looks like it's more evenly spaced, because this one's only about 15 or so inches apart, where this one's about 18 to 20. So I'm gonna go with that one. Let's get my pliers. This might be easier too if I jack my truck up, but I'm just putting the steps in. I'm not worried about it rolling away or anything like that or squashing me. All four wheels are on the ground, emergency brakes on. Got one. Got two. Oh, I should mention that I don't have any stock steps to remove, so that's makes this about half the work as it normally would if I had other steps to take off first. So I would imagine if you guys have stock steps on your truck, then you don't need to worry about pulling all these little plugs, that they're already removed for you. So that plug right there kind of gets in the way. I'm gonna pull that out, just see what it's behind. I don't think it's really anything. But I also wanna mention that in the installation instructions, when it tells you to thread these in here, it says don't tighten down super tight. I'm assuming that's so that we can kind of wiggle everything into place exactly where you want it when you're putting the steps on, just to account for any slight. I should bring all my tools with me. I'm probably almost all the way out. Not all of them have been that cooperative. Screws. next bracket. It's starting to roll pretty easy now. That's a little loosey-goosey. There we go. Like I said, those tools aren't really necessary. They're not called for in the instructions or anything like that. I just grab them because it makes it easier. Let's see, is a 6-inch fit up in here? Barely. Just barely, all the way on this aft one. Sorry, rear. My truck is super dirty. She needs to go to the car wash. Alright. So, now you guys can see, got one bracket here. They're all pretty evenly spaced here. So yeah, now we got the passenger side brackets on. They're all pretty evenly spaced, running up from the front all the way back. All right, so the next step in the directions is to install these things. But it does say to position three of these U-brackets inside the running board body. So you can see here that it's got these lips on either side where these you're gonna put them this way and turn it. And that's how the running board is gonna attach to these. To the brackets right here through those holes. It's important to note that when you put these in, make sure the flat side is down, or what will be down. Right now the running board's upside down, so otherwise you're gonna have these bolts are not gonna thread into the nuts that are just welded in here. They're not gonna go in there correctly, so make sure you put them flat side down, or up in this case, because the board's upside down. You can see here is how this is going to slide in there. It's one bracket. I'm going to slide it over the top of this. Slide back this way so I can see what I'm working with here. And then you're going to line up the bolt hole through the bracket and then screw these guys in. You're going to do that rinse and repeat for all four of your mounting brackets. And then there's nothing super clear in the instructions on how far forward or back this should go, your step. So once you get these things in here and secure, you can slide them back and forth and figure out exactly where you want your steps to be, which is kind of cool. There's a lot of adjustability that I wasn't expecting. If I was gonna go out, you can come closer to the vehicle, you can go backwards and go forwards almost as far as you want to go so you're running into the mud flaps. So I'm gonna get these all hooked up and then we'll see how it goes for adjustment here. There we go. And of course, the nice thing about metal is it's not always exactly flat and straight the way it should be. So, you might have to work around some of it. Thank you. I should way easier sitting outside the truck instead of under the truck to get these lined up. Pro tip for you. So, now we've got all of our brackets installed. Our step is essentially installed. It's just a matter of where do I want my step adjusted. And I think I'm going to slide it forward so that the front of the step is just about even with the opening of the front door. I think that looks probably the best. I've got them pulled out away from the truck as far as I can. And that will allow the maximum amount of step space, especially for my kids and for my wife who sit on this side of the truck. All right, so now I'm just going back through and I'm gonna tighten all these bolts in, make sure that my new steps don't move on the passenger side. As I said before, there's no torque specified on here, so I'm gonna give them nice and snug. Give them a little bit extra. Take it for a road test and see how it goes. Fit up there with the 6-inch extension. Around so you can see what I'm doing here. Bottom one. Bottom brackets here for the step. Slip off there, it'll be all right. A rounded off bolt never hurt anybody. And then we'll slide all the way down and do the last one. That's better. All right. These things are on there pretty sturdy.
That's gonna wrap it up for our review and install of the RB20 running boards in textured black, fitting 2019 and newer Sierra 1500 crew cabs. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, for all things Sierra, be sure to stick with us right here at AmericanTrucks.com.